Hey everyone, welcome back to a whole new session from Edureka. My name is Vajiha, and in this session, we shall do an ultimate face-off between the two very popular web development frameworks, that is Angular versus React. We shall first begin our discussion with a small introduction to Angular and React, followed by their licensing and the kind of DOM that these frameworks use. Next, we shall take a look at data binding in each of these frameworks and what are the key features that each of them offers. Following that, we shall compare both of these frameworks based on speed and productivity, deployment, learning curve, market trends, and community support. So before we begin, just make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest Edureka videos. Also, if you are interested in getting an online training certification in Angular, check out the link given in the description box below. So without any further delays, let's move on. Angular was developed by Google, and its first release dates back to 2010. The first version of Angular was also known as AngularJS. On the other hand, React was developed by Facebook in the year 2013. So coming towards the architecture of these frameworks, Angular and React both are component-based frameworks, but Angular makes use of TypeScript and HTML, whereas React, which is a user interface library, makes use of JavaScript and JSX. JSX is nothing but a syntax extension for JavaScript. The latest version of Angular, that is Angular 9, was released on the 7th of February, 2020. One of the core features of this major release is the Angular IV. To know more about the Angular IV, you can check out the Angular 9 video and blog from Edureka, whose link is mentioned in the description box below. Talking about React, the latest major version of React is React version 16. The rendering process. Angular performs client-side rendering. However, it can be rendered on the server side as well using Node.js. On the other hand, rendering is done on the server side in case of React. Websites built using these frameworks. YouTube, as we all know, is the world's largest video sharing platform owned by Google, and this is built on Angular. Another very popular online payments application website, PayPal, also runs on Angular. Other popular websites that use Angular are Walmart, which is a multinational retail corporation, and Gmail, which, as we all know, is an email service platform. I'm sure, after listening to this, many of you would have felt, wow, Angular is amazing. But let me tell you guys that React is nowhere behind. Facebook is the developer of React, and yes, Facebook makes use of React as well. Other popular applications such as Instagram, which is a photo sharing platform, and WhatsApp, which is a cross-platform messaging app, Airbnb, where you can book your stays for your vacation, are also built on React. So moving on towards the licensing of these two frameworks. Both Angular 9 and React 16 come under the MIT license. MIT, or the Massachusetts Institute of Technology license, is an open source license. Sometimes, it's also called as the BSD style license, and it has minimal software redistribution requirements. The DOM, or the document object model. Angular makes use of real DOM, while React uses virtual DOM. The real DOM updates the entire tree structure for HTML tags. It does not make much difference in a simple application, but if you are dealing with large amount of data requests on the same page, it affects the performance as well as the user experience. Hence, real DOM actually offers low performance with complex and dynamic applications. At times, real DOM becomes extremely difficult to handle because the whole tree data structure is updated even if a minor change has been made. Virtual DOM, on the other hand, has its components attached. This gives the comfort of navigation within a website. Virtual DOM is also a node tree that lists out elements and their attributes as objects. React's render function creates a node tree out of the React components. Then, it updates this tree in response to the mutations in the data model caused by various actions done either by the user or by the system. Virtual DOM is not browser specific and it is lightweight. It is provided in React package for free and eliminates the issues of slow performance of real DOM. Having said this, I'm sure you would have understood that virtual DOM is better than real DOM. Data binding. Angular uses two-way data binding, event binding, and property binding. In event data binding, Angular allows you to bind events along with the methods. Property binding of Angular will allow you to pass data from the component class and set the value to given element at the user end. Property binding also allows you to control element's property. Two-way data binding is a very important feature of Angular. With this, Angular allows you to make changes from the views to the models and from the models to the views. React, unlike Angular, allows one-way data binding. Here, the UI elements can be changed only after changing the model state. The developers, however, cannot alter the UI elements without updating the corresponding models. A great advantage of using the one-way data binding is that throughout the application, the data flows in a single direction, which gives you better control over it. This makes our application more flexible and leads to increased efficiency. So, talking about the latest features of Angular 9 and React 16. Angular 9 has a number of new features, which are: compilation of application with Ivy is default in Angular 9. Your Angular 9 application is compiled ahead of time. This means the Angular's AOT compiler will compile all the HTML and TypeScript present in your code into JavaScript before your browser downloads and runs it. This conversion takes place during the build process itself, and it also includes type checking. Angular 9 requires TypeScript 3.7. Any lower versions are not supported. TSLib, or the TypeScript runtime library, has also been made a peer dependency rather than a direct one. Earlier, this library was installed automatically, but now you will have to explicitly add this using NPM or yarn. React version 16 allows you to build great user experience models with concurrent mode and suspense. Concurrent mode is a feature that helps in binding apps faster with great user experiences that can help developers achieve their goals. Suspense is also a powerful tool for carefully organizing an elegant loading sequence with a few well-defined states that progressively reveal the content. The next very important feature is that React allows you to easily create dynamic web applications and mobile applications. React also provides support for custom DOM attributes. Instead of ignoring unrecognized HTML and SVG attributes, React will now pass them through to the DOM. This has the added benefit of allowing us to get rid of most of React's attribute whitelist, and it helps in reduction of the size of the application. React, as I've already mentioned earlier, has a single-way data flow that offers a better and streamlined data overview. In React version 16, there is an increase in productivity that helps in maintenance of the React project. Reusing components is the major advantage of React. You can start with the usual components like checkbox, button, etc. Once this is done, you can move to wrapper components, which is comprised of internal logic, which makes it easier to manipulate and define objects that are used. This also ensures the consistency of application and facilitates the code maintenance. React version 16 also provides better server-side rendering and error handling. In this version, the server is completely rewritten and it is very fast. It also supports streamlining, so you can start sending bytes to the client faster. So now moving on towards the next comparison factor, which is the speed and productivity. Talking in terms of Angular, earlier, Angular was heavier and a little slower compared to React. But now, thanks to the Angular CLI, that the app size of Angular has been drastically reduced and offers enhanced development experience. The Angular CLI empowers in creating a workspace and designs functioning applications quickly. It also empowers in producing components and services with one-line commands. Angular CLI ensures the clean coding feature of TypeScript. Before I start the discussion over React, let me just tell you what is Redux. Redux is an open-source JavaScript library for managing the state of the application. It is most commonly used with React for building user interfaces. So coming towards React, the development speed and productivity slightly get affected due to the involvement of third-party libraries like Redux. However, React is easier, lighter, and faster to code when it comes to small projects. But for large projects, TypeScript is preferable as it contains numerous features and components. Therefore, Angular has an edge over React when it comes to speed and productivity. Deployment. Earlier, it was complicated to deploy an Angular app. But now, thanks to Angular Firebase, Angular 9 has officially added support to Firebase and Angular apps, and therefore, Angular apps are now easier to deploy to Firebase. React, as I've already mentioned earlier, is lighter, and the size of the application is smaller. Therefore, it becomes easy to deploy the applications created using React. These applications are usually deployed using Node.js. The learning curve. Learning curve in Angular is quite steep as Angular provides numerous features, options, and components. For React, the learning curve is easy as React is a relatively small library and has fewer concepts to learn when compared to Angular. And for those who want to learn web development quickly and the project requirement is not too large, can go along with React. So now coming towards something very important and interesting, which is the market trend. The numbers that you see on the screen are taken from TechTrends website. According to TechTrends, there is a close competition in the job market for both these frameworks. However, Angular holds a slight upper hand overall. Moving on towards the final factor of comparison, which is community support. According to the 2019 Stack Overflow survey, it is clearly shown that React has topped among the web frameworks, making React the most loved and supported framework by developers. However, Angular is not far behind as it has good developer support by Google. Both these frameworks have very good community support. So this brings us to the end of the nail-biting face-off between Angular and React. When it comes to choosing between these two, take a look at what you wish to create and what features suit you the best. Do let us know about your personal favorites and the reason for you to choose it. If you have any doubts or queries, please do let me know in the comment section and I will revert to you at the earliest. We'll be back with more and more exciting sessions, but till then, goodbye and take care.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!